Hello friends, today in this lecture we will see a computation of a total head of pumping, or also known as the system head curve. Okay, also known as the system head curve. Okay, now we know the total head of pumping is given by H is equal to, this is the total head of pumping is given by HS plus V square by 2G plus HL. Okay, where this HS is equal to static head, that is static head, which is nothing but HS plus HD, suction head plus delivery head. Okay, then V square by 2G is nothing but the velocity head at the point of discharge, velocity head at point of discharge, point of discharge. Okay, and HL is the head loss due to friction in piping bay end walls etc. Okay, so this is what the total head we can get it. Now if let's say the pump is running, okay, if the pump is running and the discharge of the pump is more than its inflow, in that case the level of the liquid in the sump will fall. Okay, so let's say this is the level of sump initially, and if the discharge is more, then this level will go on decreasing over here. Okay, let's say I am measuring HS over here from the center of pump. As this particular level goes on decreasing, this HS will go on increasing. Okay, so the suction head component of total head will increase. Okay, also if suppose the size of pipe is changed, if pipe size will be changed, the velocity of flow will change, which will vary to change the velocity head. Okay, so pipe size is changed, velocity will change, and because of that velocity head will be changed. Static head will change because of the fall in the that particular level of liquid. Okay, so this will cause, suppose pipe velocity is changing, ultimately it will change the head loss due to friction. So this total head varies with the varying flow rate and the discharge. Okay, so either the flow rate will change or the discharge will change, the total head will be varied. Okay, hence the plot of total head of pumping versus flow rate is known as the system head curve, which is I have drawn over here. So the plot of total head versus discharge is known as the system head curve. So this particular line or the curve is known as the system head curve, where this is nothing but the HS and this is nothing but the V square by 2G plus HL. Okay, from the system head curve one can know that the total head would be for most average operating condition. Okay, so that we can know that what will be the total head for the most average operating condition. So this is what the system head curve. Okay, now we will see operating point or operating range of a centrifugal pump. Okay, now the operating point of a centrifugal pump, it is a point of intersection of the system head curve with the head discharge curve. Okay, so I have drawn the plot over here. So you can see this is the system head curve and this is what the head discharge curve. So the intersection point of these two curves is nothing but the operating point P. Now this system head curve gives the head demanded by a pumping system for a particular discharge. So this will give what is the head demanded by the pump system, okay, for a particular discharge. Now the point P, that is the head demanded by the system, is equal to the head for the particular discharge. Now in this the point P is the head demanded by the system is equal to the operating head for a particular discharge. Okay, so this is the point P of intersection. So it will give the head demanded by the system as well as the operating head of the pump particular for the particular discharge. Okay, if the system head curve changes, suppose this particular system head curve is changing, then the point P will be shifted. Okay, this point P will be shifted, and this significant change will occur because of the change in level of the sump. Okay, so there are different type of system head curve corresponding to the lower water level, corresponding to lower water level and higher water level. Okay, we'll see that now. So this is the plot for lower water level head curve and the higher water level head curve. So this is the higher water level head curve, this is the lower water head curve, and this is the head versus discharge curve. Now this from P1 to P2, this P1 to P2 is nothing but the operating range of a pump. Okay, due to the fluctuation in the water level or the sump level, this is what we can say the operating level of a operating range of the pump. Okay, so this is what the operating point or the operating range of centrifugal pump. Okay, now we will see the operating point or the operating range for the pumps which are in series. Okay, so in this case the head curve is plotted, also the H versus Q curve for individual pump is plotted for a different discharge, and the plot of head versus Q also plotted for the head equal to the sum of heads of individual pump for the same varied discharges. So this is what the plot I have drawn. So in this you can see this is the system head curve, this is the system head curve, this is the head versus Q plot for the single pump, and this is the head versus Q plot for the sum of the heads of more than one pump. Suppose there are two pumps, I have written two pumps. So this is the head versus Q for the two pumps. Okay, so this is the sum of heads. Okay, this is the curve for the sum of heads versus the Q for the two pumps. Okay, now here you can see that point of intersection of combined, that is the total head discharge characteristics and the system head curve. So P2 is larger than P1. Okay, so the P2 is larger than P1. Okay, and also H1 is with respect to P1, H2 is with respect to P2. So H2 is we can say that H2 is less than 2H1. It is less than 2H1. So though I am using two pumps, it is not like that the head will be double. It is not like the head will be double. So to get that, what we can say, particular combination of head, particular combination of pump is need to be selected. So this is how we can select the pumping unit. Okay, so based on the head, we can select the pumping unit. Okay, so when there is a series combination, we will be using this for the more larger head. Okay, so though I am using two pump, it is not that the head will be double. Okay, so accordingly we will be selecting the pumping unit. So this is the selection of pump using pumps in series. Now we'll see the selection of pumping unit when the pumps are in parallel. Okay, in this again, as like in the pumps in series, we will be plotting the system head curve. So this is the system head curve. First we will be plotting, then we will plot the H versus Q plot for the single pump. Okay, and also we will be plotting the H versus Q plot for the sum of the discharges of two pump versus Q versus head. Okay, so this is what the plot of sum of discharges, okay, versus H. So this is the plot we will be plotting. So these two plots will be plotted. Then we can see the point of intersection for a single pump and point of intersection for the two pump. So the point of intersection for the two pump is higher than the point of intersection for the single pump. Okay, accordingly we'll be having the Q1 with respect to the simple single pump and Q2 with respect to the double pump or the two pumps. Now here we can see the Q2 is less than 2Q1, is less than 2Q1. Okay, so again, as like in the series, it is not like if I am using two pump, I'll be getting the double discharge. I'll be getting the double discharge. It is not like the case. Okay, so we will be selecting a proper unit, a proper pumping unit, according to the requirement of the discharge. Okay, so this is what the how we can select the pumping unit. Okay, thank you.